This is what it looks like when you skydive with regular armor, and this is what it looks like when you skydive with the glide set. You can see how fast you're moving in comparison to the other one. And I'm gonna be showing you exactly how to get it and get it pretty quick. Stick around to the end of the video because I'm gonna be showing you the secret set bonus that this armor gives you. The first place we need to go is Mount Lineru's Skyview Tower. Head over there, and when you get to the Skyview Tower, open up your map, pan up to the sky, and mark up this island above you. We're gonna head to that purple marker. So go ahead and lift off. Once you're up in the air, just direct yourself a little bit northeast towards that location. Make sure you're carefully gliding and conserving energy because it is actually that sky island at the bottom over there. If you can't reach the bottom island that quick, you can go to one of the topper parts of it and make your way down if your stamina is happening to run low. And that should be exactly one bar of stamina for you guys. Continue here and now head carefully towards that next island. You should see a little pond over there on the sky island. Once you arrive here, immediately go and talk to the construct. When you talk to the construct, it'll talk to you about a skydiving challenge practice session. Go ahead and start that. Immediately, you'll get the start and you just dive off of this cliff. Now, what you have to do is just aim so that you can go through these circles. And be careful because this one is a little bit cloudy because this one's very tall. So you have to pass through the clouds and just make sure to follow that dot that drops down and makes the circle. Just that's all you got to keep your eyes on. Don't look for the circle, just follow the line. And that should tell you where to go. So just glide and dive. If you happen to ever mess up, open up your parachute at any moment, just so you can get back on course and not fall through and fail this. And then the final one's always going to be dead center at the bottom. After that, a shrine will be activated. So go ahead and head over to the shrine just to click on it. That way you can fast travel to this island at any time you want. Head back after unlocking that shrine and go ahead and talk to the construct again. And this time you're actually going to be doing the challenge and it's going to cost you one Zonai charge. So go ahead, give him that and begin the challenge and just rinse and repeat and do that one more time. Once you finish the challenge and do it under the time that was given by the construct, he will go ahead and then hand you the glide mask, which is one piece of your set. All right, let's go to the next spot. The next tower that you want to go to is going to be the one at Linzor's Brow Skyview Tower. If you want to know where that is exactly to the west of Hyrule Castle. So once you're here, you're going to lift off and launch off. What you want to do is put your marker by this island over here that looks like a swirl, and you'll notice there's another lake or pond at the bottom. So I'm going to be heading right in that direction. So just make your way there carefully. You can try to skydive down from the top if you feel like practicing. I don't feel like practicing because the boss is going to tell me to do that. So I'm just going to go ahead and drop a little bit. And you can see maybe that your mobility has increased just a tiny bit because you put on the mask. Fly through this area. Don't hit any rocks. Don't bang into anything. And when you're close to the bottom floor, just like that, you can go ahead and full send into that pond or lake. There we go. I full send it into it. By the way, once you're in this area, you'll also notice that even in the first one, there are little fairies floating around. You probably want to grab these fairies when you're here, and it's actually a good place to farm them. So whenever you're at any of the islands that we're going to be talking about, go ahead and grab these fairies, because if you take a hit, they'll bring you back to life. Anyway, once you're here, talk to the construct again, then go ahead and just jump off. Follow down these lines. This one's not as cloudy as the last one we went to, so here we go. It's pretty easy. I'm pretty sure you could just straight up dive and follow it. It's not too bad here. And if you're wearing the headpiece you got from the previous one, it should be easier to move in this. And then just drop down over here and you're done. After that, the construct will unlock the shrine over by you and mention of the other challenge. Just do the exact same thing we did in the other island. This shrine is the Taoni Shrine. I'm really bad at this. Taoni Shrine. Let me know in the comments how you pronounce these things. Go back to the construct, and when you talk to the construct, give it a Zonai charge. And when you give it the Zonai charge, just rinse and repeat what you just did. While we're falling down this sky challenge, you should probably hit that subscribe button so that Link can beat Ganondorf and get us to 500k. Seriously, if you're watching it, it's simple. Just click subscribe. It's that easy. The construct will then hand you the glide shirt. The next place that you want to go is going to be the Typhlo Ruins Skyview Tower. This is literally going to be all the way at the northmost part of your map. So just go over here. And once you're here, lift off and then open up your map. And we're going to be facing down to this direction. And you can see the island's kind of obvious. There's an entire section with circles. And then there is the lake down below, or the pond. Everyone's going to say that's not a lake. Okay, it's a body of water. Careful with your stamina, depending on how much stamina you have in the game. You can drop down a little bit or skydive closer, because now you've got two pieces of the gear, so you should be able to skydive a little bit better at this point as you approach this island. Go ahead and drop in the little water once you arrive, if that's exactly where you land, just in case you're running out of stamina. And then same thing, rinse and repeat. We're going to go ahead and talk to this construct. This construct is then going to tell you to do the trial. Go ahead and do this trial. I actually think this one might be the easiest one. I think so, because it's almost like you just go straight down in this one. Yeah, this is... Oh, never mind. There we go. There we go. It is actually easy. Just go through the green circles there. And if you make a mistake, like I said, just open up your paraglider. These rings actually rotate around, so you got to... Gotta watch the rotate here. Some go clockwise, some go anti-clockwise, and then the final one is dead center and splash. After you're done, the steward construct will open up another shrine on your map. Head over to that shrine. This is the Simo Siwak Shrine. Talk to the steward construct again, and then you're going to give him one zone charge and do exactly what you did again. Once you're done with that, you'll then will be able to get the glide tights, which will increase your mobility by even more. I mean, seriously, look at this. We're just gonna hop off this island right now, and then look how fast we can move. So then when you're facing straight, you can see the distance you're getting when you push forward. That's what we mean by speed. And when I mean skydive, don't aim straight down, aim at an angle. Pretty much is that's what you want to do. Now we're also going to have to upgrade it. So what you're going to need for this upgrade in the Great Fairy Fountain is just a bunch of key swings that you can find from keys that roam around in Hyrule Field at night. Usually you find them roaming around in giant groups all the time everywhere. And you also are going to need Arakuda eyes. You can find those flying in the sky. If you're too lazy to hunt Arakudas, you can head over to Kakariko and buy them over there. Now, when you finally get that level 2 upgrade, the glide armor becomes extremely OP because look at this. I could jump from any high place, fall on the ground, and take zero damage. Congrats! Now you have one of the best armors for exploration in the game. But do you have this? Check this out.